king of the Klondike, Tony Beets, is assembling his full forces. After banking 2,870 ounces from two of the deepest cuts ever mined on Paradise Hill, he's marshalling all his heavy metal in an attempt to hit a record-setting 5,000-ounce haul.
We got some decent gold out of the cold cut and the blue cut, and now we got the 80 pup hill ready to go. Hopefully it's a decent piggy bank. Let's get it out of there.
Based on youngest son Mike's recommendation, Tony's moved everything to the reopened 80 pup cut, home to the fabled gold-rich White Channel pay. But success is not guaranteed.
Down here on the hill, in a favored, all of a sudden you hit a whole pile of bedrock. And you actually really never know what are you gonna get. We're kind of out on, you know, taking our chances, so to speak. So we'll play around, we'll just see what we can get out of it.
I came up with a plan.
We're hauling pay from an 80 pop right now.
Mike's reputation as a mine boss in waiting rests upon his ability to run the full 10-acre site by season's end.
This material we're loading is sandy-ish, so it goes through really, really, really fast. So it makes it really hard to keep a stockpile. If it goes through fast, you get more gold quicker.
Okay, yeah, keep backing it up. Go a little bit straighter. Perfect, okay, you can dump it right there. Oh, there's no water at the plant.
Shut down the plant. I ain't getting no water.
I didn't have enough water?
Yeah. Not enough water. Like trying to eat dry rye bread with only a shot glass of water. Yeah, when it clogs up like that, stop, because nothing's happening.
So every minute we're down, we're losing gold. Mikey Beets has headed down to see if he can check out what's going on with the pump down below. Hopefully we can get it cleared up and figure out what's wrong with the pump and get up and going.
There's no reason for it not to be giving us enough water. So it means that pump is worn out and we're probably gonna have to get a new one.
Tony Beets, do you copy Tony Beets? Hey, Dad, the pump's Jane pumping. There ain't nothing else but it to be
this.
The 900 horsepower pump has lost all water pressure. With the chill blast of winter breathing down their necks, Tony springs into action.
Cousin Mike, do you copy? Cousin Mike, do you copy? Can you and Glenn come to the yard, please? We need some guys there. We're gonna have to fix this thing. We had that pump for 30 years, been very reliable, but at one point you're gonna have to say goodbye and get the new one in there. We luckily have a new pump on site. We just have to put it on behind the engine.
At least we'll have a new spare sitting there. If you don't have a spare in the Yukon, then you could be down for weeks, if not a month.
Tony's new pump is a beast. Using a massive 12-cylinder marine engine, it can deliver pressures of 250 PSI and pump an extra 2,000 gallons of water a minute. To make it operational, an old housing unit will need to be modified, allowing the new pump to line up precisely with the engine. Tony plans to cut a hole in the base, use a crane to hang the pump in the correct position, then finally, weld a new beam and steel plate to secure it.
Are you ready to go to the boneyard?
Yep.
Okay, go find the piece iron.
And Until Cousin Mike and Len get the new pump running, the Beets will be shut down.
This is going to take us a couple days to pull off. We can't sluice without water. We need that thing on the go now. Pump is still down. We have no trommel running. We're not getting any gold.
Klondike legend Tony Beets has been shut down for 2 days, waiting on a key piece of kit. With White Channel pay ready to be pulled from the 80 pup cut, Tony can at last transport his new 11-ton mega pump to the sluice pond. Once on site,
okay, get that thing in position.
It's all hands on deck to fire up the pump and get back to washing pay dirt.
Okay, Mike, lift it up. Okay, just like that, Mike, swing it out a little bit. Good, lower that down. Perfect, lower it down. Good enough. Good.
This is how we're gonna hook up our pump to our sluice pond.
It's always nice to see it, that it goes to the place where it should be, but it's not running yet.
I can't wait to see this down turn, actually. It will be very nice. Ready? Well, see what noise it makes. You got fuel pressure, Len? Okay, crank. 1, 2, 3, 4.
What's that?
Give it more throttle.
Those are gonna be oil operated. I think we need to put air to the system.
With the pump's engine failing to turn over.
Everybody ready? 3, 2, 1, kaboom.
Tony gives it a bump by spraying ether, known as starting fluid, into the air intake of the 700 horsepower engine.
It won't start. This one is empty. I have no idea what that air will do, none. It's frustrating. I'll give her a bit of persuasion.
Use this for boost?
Oh, you want to. Swing it around, bingo. Okay, hook it up.
We're giving it additional power to help it turn over. It didn't quite sound like it had enough juice last time. And we want to be sure that it's going to go this time. So we got the air, new starter, new power, going in the pump. It's going to go.
Kevin's plan is to give the pump a jump start. Using the pipe layer.
Are you ready, Freddy? Kevin?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, fire the up. Engine is beautiful.
Sounds way nicer than the other one.
Well, yeah, we'll probably get 20, 30, 40,000 hours less on it, too.
Oh, at least.
Well, that's good to have that pump up and running. Now we can go back sluicing. I think it's good.
The new pump will send 1,500 gallons of water a minute, half a mile up the hill to the waiting trommel.
Perfect.
Good to go. Don't have enough water pressure. All right, gotta get some pay dirt through this beast.
After a 3-day shutdown, it's imperative the 80 pup pays out big to make up for lost time.